Welcome back to SNS Grills. I'm Jabin from Postal Barbecue, and today we're making a monster breakfast burrito using the SNS Grills plancha griddle. I'm gonna be filling up the entire surface of the plancha with all of my favorite breakfast foods, wrapping it up to make this insanely good breakfast burrito. Take a look. As I said, welcome back to SNS Grills. If you're new here, make sure to hit that subscribe button as well as that notification bell for more great barbecue recipes just like this one. Today, we're gonna be making a delicious breakfast burrito using the SNS Grills plancha. It's 23 pounds and 1/4 inch of carbon steel, which makes it a real joy to cook on because you're not gonna have to deal with any warping. It's polished nice and smooth and has a great user experience when you pair it with the slow and sear kettle. So when getting ready to make a breakfast burrito like this, one of the best things that you can do is prepare all of your ingredients in advance because once it hits the plancha, the cook goes very quickly. And so you don't want to be messing around with having to cut vegetables, cut bacon, whatever it is you're going to be prepping. You want to do that all in advance just to simplify the whole cooking process. So in our breakfast burrito today, we're going to be keeping it somewhat simple, but we're going to add in some fresh components that are really just going to help elevate this burrito. I started out by chopping up about 8 pieces of bacon, as well as pulled out another 8 links of sausage. We also have some eggs, as well as some hash browns that we're gonna cook up on the plancha. And then I've diced up everything that's needed to make a fresh homemade pico that we're gonna top inside of this burrito. And so this is really easy to make. I'm first gonna take 2 Roma tomatoes and place that in my dish. I have 1/2 of a diced onion. We're gonna take a pinch of cilantro, toss that in there as well. We have 1/2 of a diced jalapeno. We're also gonna take about 1/2 of a lime, and we're gonna squeeze some fresh lime into this as well. There we go. Then we're gonna season it with a little bit of salt and pepper. There we go. And then we're just gonna mix this all together. And as you can see, because I did dice all these up in advance, the process of making this pico is really simple, and it's gonna taste really nice in that burrito that we're gonna be making. Then the last thing we're gonna prepare is a nice spicy lime crema. So we have about 1/3 cup of sour cream. Place that in there, as well as 1/3 cup of mayo. We're gonna take a little bit of a lime here. It's about 1/3 lime. We're gonna squeeze that in as well. Then to that, we're gonna add in a little bit of hot sauce, and this is gonna give it our spice. And so use your favorite hot sauce. This is one of mine, especially when it comes to breakfast. Mix that all together. Right, that is mixed. And so with our fresh pico made, as well as our spicy lime crema, we're gonna go ahead and get the SNS Grills plancha all set up for grilling. So to set up our plancha today, you'll notice that I removed the slow and sear basket from the slow and sear kettle. I then filled up a chimney basket full of unlit briquettes and got those mostly lit. Once they're mostly lit, I then dumped them into the slow and sear kettle, resting them on the back of the bowl. I also have my bottom vent wide open, as well as the smoke hole can be either open or closed for this cook. I then place the plancha back into the grill and let it come up to temperature. So our plancha is all set up in the slow and sear kettle, and I've set it up with a few different zones at the back where our coal is. It would be our hot zone. And then we have our general cooking area, which is gonna be in this area. And then this front section we'll use just to keep things warm, or if we need to just bring things up slowly to temperature. And so with our plancha all set up and ready to go, we need to first begin to cook some of our items based off of the time required to cook them. And so we're gonna start with our hash browns, and we're gonna first of all throw down some butter onto the plancha. Then we're gonna take our hash browns and place those onto the griddle. Then we're just gonna mix them around. And so for our hash browns, we're utilizing the hottest part of the plancha because we really want to develop a little bit of a crust on the outside of those hash browns. Next, we're going to add on our sausages. And then we're gonna place on our bacon as well onto the cooler side. And so we're just gonna let that bacon sort of hang out and cook. It's still quite warm on the front, and so those are just gonna slowly cook for us to the texture that we like. We're not gonna go super crispy with our bacon today. We just want it to have a nice bite to that bacon. And so what I'm doing with the hash browns is I'm just laying them as flat as I can because it opens up the surface area. And so we're gonna get a lot more browning to those hash browns than if there was just one big pile. So we're at that time when things are starting to be finished. Our sausages are done as well as our hash browns are looking done. And so I'm gonna move some of this stuff over into the cool zone. Then I'm gonna take all of my hash browns and slide them to the back of the plancha just to keep warm. Then we'll finish off our bacon on the hot zone of our plancha. Our bacon is done, so let's move it again off to the cool zone. So our hash browns, our sausage, and our bacon are all done. And so it's now time to do the eggs. And there's really two ways you could do it. The first way is you could place a cast iron pan on top of the plancha to contain everything, or you can go very slowly and slowly pour it onto the plancha, stirring it so that it doesn't run off the sides. And so that's what we're gonna do today. And so we're gonna just slowly pour it on. Go. And just keep stirring that around. And then the last step that we're gonna do is when our eggs are mostly cooked, we're gonna add a little bit of salt onto them just to season them up. Stir that in. There we go. And so I'm gonna call those eggs done. And so I'm gonna actually take them off the plancha now because I don't want them to cook any more than they're already cooked. And we'll just set that off to the side. And so the last thing that we need is our flour tortilla. And you're gonna wanna heat this up. And so we're gonna just utilize this space on the plancha and place that on. And we're just gonna heat up that flour tortilla just a few seconds on either side to allow us to wrap our burrito a little bit easier. There we go. Okay, so to build our burrito, the first thing that we're gonna do is take some shredded cheese. We're gonna place this onto the bottom. And then we're gonna grab some of our hash browns. We're gonna place those on there as well. We'll grab a few more of those. To that, I'm gonna add on some of our sausages. We're gonna do two on either side. Look at that. And so I'm building it this way because I want those layers to be there once it's been wrapped. So I'm gonna throw on some of our egg. And then I'm gonna grab some of our bacon. We're gonna load the bacon on top of those eggs. Look at that, that looks so good. We're also gonna hit it with just a little bit more cheese on top of that. And then from here, this is where we're gonna hit it with some of that pico that we made. And then we're gonna drizzle some of that spicy lime crema on top as well. And then lastly, we're gonna hit it with a little bit more cilantro, and look at that, that looks amazing. All right, so this is the fun part, the wrapping. And you'll notice that I went for the larger style tortilla because I have a tendency to overstuff my burritos. And you know, if this was a smaller size, I definitely would have overstuffed it. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab the front and I'm gonna fold it over. I'm gonna just pinch it down in the front, then pull back just slightly. We're gonna fold it into itself, fold it over on the sides, and then we're just gonna keep rolling this, and look at that, just like that. And look at that, it's a perfect breakfast burrito. And so the last thing that we're gonna do is I'm gonna place it back on the plancha just to grill up that tortilla just a little bit. There we go. And so we're basically just gonna leave it on there just to get a little bit of color on the outside of that tortilla. We're gonna flip it over, and then during that process I'm gonna make a second one, then we'll come back and get ready for the taste test. Just look at these breakfast burritos. They're absolutely gorgeous. You can see all of the ingredients that we put in there just shining through. I know that this is gonna be an amazing breakfast burrito. And so let's go for the taste test. Mm-hmm. You know, I don't know what to say. This is phenomenal. You can taste all of those classic breakfast ingredients that we cooked on the plancha, and you can really taste all of the ingredients in this burrito. The first thing that you notice is that richness from the bacon and the sausage and that cheese just coming through really nicely, but it's then balanced really nicely with that fresh homemade pico that we made and that squeeze of lime that's in it. Oh, it's delicious. You know, if you've never made a breakfast burrito like this before, make sure to give it a try because it's so good. And when you cook it on the plancha, it's just a really fun user experience. And so with that said, I'm gonna go ahead and finish off this burrito, and I'm gonna save this one for another time. This breakfast burrito is filling, fun to make, and has all the best breakfast foods wrapped into one. You're gonna love it. So make sure to give it a try, and remember, two zones are better than one.